Integration by parts. What do you mean by integration by parts? Means it is the formula when you are having two functions in product. When you are having two functions in product, you have to apply this formula. Suppose it is f of x and then direct f of x. Integral g of x and g of x as common. Can you multiplication on it? For example, it is x into log x and then. If you put integral x as x square by 2, then what is integral log x? Is there formula? No formula for log x. Integral log x, no formula. So for such type of product functions, to evaluate integration of such type of product functions, this formula is derived, which is called integration by parts. What is the formula? Integral f of x into g of x means f of x integral g of x dx minus integral f dash of x integral g of x dx whole dx. Integral f of x into g of x dx means, read, f of x integral g of x dx minus integral of f dash of x. F dash of x means derivative of f of x integral g of x dx malli mottaniki whole dx. In some colleges, they will derive or define the formula in terms of uv. Integral uv. Okay. Integral uv, what they will say simply, u integral v minus integral u dash integral v whole dx. They will say like this. Okay. It's another method of remembering the formula in terms of uv. Anyway, you remember, the method of integrating, you have to remember. What is that? First function, integral of second. The technique is, suppose you are having first function into second function dx. Means you should remember like this. First function, integral of second function, minus derivative of first, integral of second, whole dx, like this. But my suggestion is to remember this formula. These are the other methods of lecturers. In other college, lecturers will teach this method or this method. My suggestion is to remember this method. So, first. Now let us do an example sum. Integral x into log x dx. Now, which one you should take as f of x? Here you are having two functions. Which function you have to take f of x, which function you have to take g of x, to decide that there is a rule. Without following that rule, if you take whatever function f of x and g of x, you will not get the answer. So for that you are having a rule which is called Eilert rule. What a BGM. Eilert rule. I stands for inverse functions. Inverse functions means like sin inverse, cos inverse, tan inverse, like that. L means logarithms, like this. A means algebraic, like x, x square, x cube, 1, root x, 1 by x, all those. T means trigonometric, you know everything what is trigonometric. E means exponential. Exponential means e power x, a power x, 4 power x, 5 power x, when the x is the power. So this rule you have to follow. This order you have to follow. Now if observing the question, x is algebraic, this is clearly logarithmic. Now in the rule, if you observe, L comes before A. Logarithmic function comes before algebraic function. So this logarithmic function you should take as f of x, and algebraic you should take as g of x. So taking f of x, g of x is very keen in this particular method. So what is the rule? The rule is Eilert rule. Eilert, you are always late. Okay, I stands for inverse functions like sin inverse, cos inverse, tan inverse, like that. L stands for logarithmic, A stands for algebraic, T for trigonometric, E for exponential. Okay, first. Write the formula. Write the formula, everyone. integral f of x into g of x dx means f of x integral g of x dx minus integral f dash of x integral g of x dx. Now write the answer. F of x, we are taking f of x as log x. Integral g of x is x dx minus integral, you are saying f dash of x means derivative of f of x. F of x is log x, no? Now can anyone tell what is derivative of log x? Derivative of log x. Okay, I'll write here. See, f of x is log x. So f dash of x means derivative of log x is 1 by x. So 1 by x. Now integral g of x. Integral g of x, x is g of x here whole dx. Now log x into, better put log x in bracket. Now integral x means formula x square by 2 minus 1 by x. Now here also integral x is integral x dx means x square by 2 dx. Now write like this, x square by 2 log x minus, right, 1 by 2 outside, x and x square get cancelled x times dx. So the answer, x square by 2 log x minus 1 by 2 into again x means x square by 2 plus c. So that is the final answer. If you want, you can take x square by 2 all common, or else leave the answer like this, or else you can write x square by 2 log x minus x square by 4 plus c. Also you can write, since this is for 2 marks only, no need of further simplification, that's also enough. So deciding f of x and g of x is very important in this model, following Eilert rule in this.